Hello. In this video, we will see surface tension in lung alveoli. To understand surface tension, first we will study some relevant chemistry of water. Then we will study surface tension in general. And finally, we will see surface tension in lung alveoli. Let's get started. The story starts with understanding chemistry of water molecule. In water molecule, one oxygen atom is bound to two hydrogen atoms by covalent bond. Now, oxygen attracts electron pair more strongly than does the hydrogen. So, electrons are pulled towards oxygen atom. This gives oxygen partial negative charge and hydrogen atoms partial positive charge. In water, there are multiple such charged molecules. Here, positively charged hydrogen atom of one water molecule attracts negatively charged oxygen atom of other water molecule. Such attraction is occurring throughout the water phase. This is all we wanted to know in chemistry part. Take home message from this discussion is, water molecules are attracted by surrounding water molecules. Now let's move the discussion towards surface tension. This is air. This is water. And this is air-water interface. In water, we have water molecules deep inside the water and on the surface. All these molecules are attracted by surrounding water molecules as we saw in previous discussion. Now look at these water molecules which are deep inside. They have water all around. So attraction in all directions is equal. The sum of this opposing force is zero. So there is no net driving force to move such water molecules. However, the situation is different at the surface. These water molecules have other water molecules on the sides and towards the bottom. But there are no water molecules to pull them upward. So these water molecules experience net force towards the bulk water phase. This net force pulls water molecules deep in. Because of this, kind of vacuum is created on the surface. Due to this, water molecules that remain on the surface develop pull towards such areas all around. This puts them in state of tension, which is called surface tension. As the molecules on the surface fill in these spots, the surface area of the interface decreases. Thus, due to surface tension, air-water interface always tries to have least surface area possible. So this was about surface tension in general. If all this explanation was overwhelming to you, just remember this. Air-water interface is like an elastic band and it always tries to decrease its surface area. Now let's study surface tension in lung alveoli. This is schematic diagram of lung. This is lung parenchyma and this is alveoli. The surface of alveoli is lined by fluid and remaining space is filled with air. So we have air-liquid interface. As we have studied in previous discussion, water molecules at this surface are under tension like an elastic band and it tries to have least surface area possible. As it does so, the alveoli collapse. If we want to expand this alveoli, we have to apply extra pressure to overcome this surface tension. In other words, the more the surface tension, the harder it is to expand the lungs. In terms of compliance, surface tension decreases compliance of lungs. There are also other problems related to high surface tension. Luckily, they are all solved by surfactants. We will study them in separate video. For now, I think this much is enough. If you struggle understanding medical concepts, subscribe to the channel and also follow me at other social media. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.